fantastic to have you here tonight. Are you looking forward to this film?
Yeah, I'm really, really excited, in fact, actually, yeah.
You're clearly dressed for the occasion, looking very dapper for the wedding-themed film.
Yeah, well, on the invite, it was like, wedding theme, optional. But I always find it really annoying, you make the effort, and like, half the people don't bother, so I thought, might as well put some nice clobber on.
Have you had any particularly interesting, entertaining wedding-based experiences yourself?
I remember when I was like 3 or 4, so it was quite a hazy memory. We were at our wedding in Kent. It was like my dad's old school friend or something. And the wedding cake falling over sort of catastrophe, it fell over. And we didn't have a wedding cake.
You make do in those situations.
Now, it was actually, it was big enough that there was, because the cake was mounded, there was parts of the cake which obviously hadn't touched the floor. So people did actually, you make do and mend. People were scooping it off the non-floory bits and eating it. So it's good.
5 second rule. Talking about making great things, what's coming up next for you work-wise? What are you on at the moment?
Well, actually, tomorrow I'm starting my first day on my first part in a drama, which is Midsummer Murders. So I'm very much looking forward to that. Also then shortly in month two, we should be starting a new series of Cuckoo. And then towards the end of the year, we'll be shooting series 5 of Outnumbered.
So much great stuff there. First of all, to start with Outnumbered, going into season 5, what are you looking forward to and what do you think fans can expect?
Well, I'm really looking forward to seeing what Andy and Guy have come up with, because obviously we've all grown an age since the last one. So I think it's going to be interesting to see how they integrate that into the storyline. And also how they, basically, we told the writers that I changed my hairstyle, and they said they were going to try and write it into the storyline somehow. And apparently Dad's going to take the mick out of me for it or something. So look forward to that.
Bullied about your hairstyle, that's what we've got to look forward to. You're going into season 5. Why do you think people love the show so much? Because it is really loved by people.
I think the show has been so popular because when it came out, it was very innovative. It kind of found that niche, I think, which was, don't work with children and animals. It was the first time people had really embraced working with young children. And I think it kind of had a sort of magic to it where loads and loads of people could relate to it. Not only could young children relate to it, parents could relate to it, but also grandparents could relate to it, and grandparents who had grandchildren, grandparents who had, when their children were young and stuff. I just think it appealed to quite a wide audience.
Of course, fans will have their highlights, their favourite episodes, their favourite moments. Are there any in particular that make you especially smile or you're especially proud of?
There was one episode. In terms of the episode itself, it's probably not my favourite, but it was my most favourite to work on. And it was episode 3 from series 1 where we go to a farm, and it was so much fun because basically every second we weren't filming, I was playing mini golf with Hugh, and it was really fun.
You mentioned there, of course, Cuckoo, more of that coming up. What can we expect from the next batch of that?
Oh, I have to tell you, I've got no idea really, because I think the concept for the first series, Cuckoo coming along and stuff, I think it was really, really fantastic, but I don't really know where they're going to take it now. So I'm just as intrigued as you are to see where that's going to go.
It is an intriguing series. What do you think it was about the premise of that really caught people? Because it did hook people quite early on, I think.
Yeah, I think it was, I think what was likeable about it is because initially Cuckoo comes in and he's so annoying and it's like really, really, he's just getting in the way and making all these funny situations and stuff. But over the course of the series, I think you really, really warm to him, and you see that he absolutely adores Rachel, and he's a lovely person. And I just think the magic of the series is the fact that by about episode 3, you're basically thinking you're just in love with Cuckoo, and I think it's a lovely way to end the series with them getting remarried and then Greg and Cuckoo kissing.
I mean, the final thing you mentioned, you're about to go off, and is it one of your sort of big dramas, and Midsummer Murder? Was it? Is it Midsummer Murders? Who are you playing in that? Where do you fit into that one?
I'm playing a chef called Ferdy. He works in a kitchen, as chefs do. But that's my character.
A victim or a murderer?
I can't spill too much on that.
Final question, do you have a message for fans before you leave us, people who love all those shows and can't wait to see more of you on our screens?
If you're a fan of me, then thanks so much for my support. Keep the support coming, and I'll keep the requited love coming. Thanks, everyone.